But English and Welsh boxing teams are in Marquette to challenge U.S. Junior Olympians in competitions tomorrow and Saturday at 7 p.m. at the Hitchcock Fieldhouse. In tonight's TV6 Sports Spotlight, J.R. Ward shows us the way boxing is done across the pond.
When you think of European boxing, the Eastern Bloc nations tend to come to mind. But the teams from the United Kingdom are very strong, too.
The athletes that come here from Wales and England are going to be strong. European boxers traditionally are. They're upright, they come at you, and I expect a very good competition.
Boy. Since the U.S. is one of the best at international competition, everyone's out to get them.
Our international teams have competed against Ireland, which are very strong and drawn. We drew against your own junior American team last year. So yes, we are in a strong position at the moment.
Strong team. Americans have a strong team. I was part of the team which drew with them last year and I won. And I'm confident I can win this year as well.
When the Americans come over to England, I was meant to box, but there wasn't a boy in my weight. And when I turned up, there was a boy in my weight, but I didn't have a medical card, so I couldn't box. But I hope to box this Saturday anyway.
This is the young boxer's first trip to the U.S., but sightseeing is the least on their minds.
The boys are enjoying it. They want to go out a little bit more, want a bit more freedom, but they come here to do a job and make sure they do it before they have a right good time.
The climate surrounding the U.K. boxers has been nothing but one of goodwill. As an example, yesterday a wallet containing several hundred dollars was found by an American boxer and returned to his British counterpart, who owned it.
And I think that put this competition into perspective. Why we're here is to join the youth of the world together.
Goodwill or not, the Americans better watch out because
the British are coming.
J.R. Ward, TV6 Sports, Marquette.
Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Hedgecock Fieldhouse on the campus of Northern Michigan University for the 1991 Junior Olympic International Exchange between the athletes of Wales, England, and the United States of America. At this time, we will have the traditional exchange of gifts between the delegations. Introducing the team manager from England, Mr. Joe Shembri. With the team manager of the United States, Mr. Dave Love. Introducing the team manager from Wales, Mr. David Francis, exchanging with the head coach of the United States, Mr. Joe Souza. Introducing the coach from England, Mr. Ernie Holyoke, exchanging with Coach Manuel Montiel of the United States. Mr. Kenneth McCon, Coach of Wales, exchanging with Mr. Barney Flores of the United States. The referees for the bouts are Mr. Cyril Reynolds of Wales, exchanging with Mr. Don DeVergis of Los Angeles, California. And Mr. Terry Goldsmith of England, exchanging with Mr. Armando Garcia of Miami, Florida. Esteemed doctors for the evening at ringside will be Mr. Dr. Grant Evans of Wales and Mr. Bill Hatch of Phoenix, Arizona. And now for our contestants of the two bouts, weighing in at 85 pounds from Wales, Mr. Paul Chapman, going against at 119, representing England, Mr. Thomas DeLee, from the United States, Eric Hopkins. At 125 pounds, representing England, Mr. Michael Jones. Craig Kelly, from the United States. representing England at 132, Mr. Michael Hall. And from the United States, from Hawaii, Blaze Soares. At 139 pounds from England, Mr. Sean Gray. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise for the plane of the three national